Hi guys, welcome to C2C Mentors. In this video, we have with us Garima. Garima scored 98.88 percentile in CAT 2020 and she has converted IIM Calcutta this year. So let's hear it from her. How was her CAT preparation journey so that we can get many more insights for the future aspirants? Over to you, Garima. Why don't you start by introducing yourself and telling us something about your profile?
Okay, so hi, I'm Garima and I've done my BSc in Physical Science with Chemistry from Hindu College, Delhi University. And I just graduated in 2020 and that is when I started preparing for CAT, actually towards the end of April. So in my 10th, I scored 93.1% and in my 12th, I got 93.2%. Of course, it was a CBSE board. And in my grads, I got 8.12 overall percentile. And I think I'm, other than that, I think I'm a fresher and I started preparing in April and till November, I did not do any particular job or internship. So I focused completely on CAT.
So there are many students this year also who are in their final year aiming for CAT. It is their first attempt. So they always have this thing in mind, how to manage our exams. We have our final year exams. Can we start post our final year exams or how is it? So what would be your take on it?
Okay, so basically when I started, it was a complete lockdown and the exams had shifted to the online mode. Of course, it was a confusing time, but it did give me more time to focus on my CAT and less to focus on the curriculum of Delhi University at that particular time because the exams kept on being postponed. But if you really want to, you know, give your CAT in the same year as you graduate, you have to give it at least 6 months. And if you start preparing after your exams, I think it gets a little bit late. But if you think you can devote that much time that you can make up for that lost time, I think that would be okay too.
So Teri Saab, you say that it's manageable for college work also and your exam also, CAT also, right? So how did you start your preparation? I mean, what was the first thing? Did you give up?
Definitely.
Or how was it? How was it? How did you start?
So the first thing I did was look up the best coaching or look up for the best material. And I signed up for that because what I thought was I had to be clear on the basics of the concepts first. Whenever someone starts preparing for CAT, they get, you know, in that spiral of tricks and shortcuts, especially for the quant section. But I had one motto clear that there can be a million shortcuts, right? But there are only a few basics. And if I get clarity on that particular basics, I could, you know, make up my own tricks and shortcuts. So that was the first thing that I did. And the second strategy that I used was I started giving mocks from the very first week of my preparation. Like it did not matter that how many topics I was familiar with or comfortable with. I started giving mocks from the very first week and then I tracked my progress. I maintained charts. And I also analyzed those mocks later on. But I think I started this way.
Yeah. And how important you think is making notes while you're studying? Because many people think that they are not able to make notes or making notes is pretty time consuming. So what was your take on that?
Yeah. So I'm someone who, you know, reads and rereads notes, who feels comfortable when they're writing and, you know, it just gets imprinted in my memory whenever I write something down. So for me, notes were a very important factor at that time. I, in fact, had two whole registers full of notes, but of course that can be different for different people. For me, it worked out pretty well.
Like looking at you, I can feel that you must be making those proper colored pens while our notes very structured and very neat. So yeah, when, so after you started giving your mocks, how did you start analyzing those mocks? Did you give sectionals topic wise or directly the full length mocks? How was it?
So I started with the full length mocks just to get familiar with the whole concept. But later on, I moved on to the sectionals as well. And for analyzing those particular mocks, what I did was I gave at least complete 2 or 3 hours to one mock. And especially for the VA section, when it gets difficult to choose between especially the last two options, I tried to analyze what was my thought process behind the particular option that I selected. What was I thinking when I, you know, take that particular option? And if it was wrong, I tried to differentiate it from what I should have been thinking. And what I think during the exam also that worked out pretty well for me.
And coming from non-engineering background, I would say you're from physical science. So what were your areas of strengths or what were your weaker sections? How was it?
VARC was a strong point for me, and DILR was also not pretty bad from my end, but I really struggled in the quant section. In fact, till my initial 10 or 15 mocks, I could not score more than 77 percentile in that particular section. So what I did was I gave sufficient amount of time, a week, couple of weeks, to just to quant section. I took up extra books and supplementary books, and I started solving those within particular time frames. And though I was familiar with the concepts, I was comfortable, but when it came to that exam situation, right, the pressure situation, I panicked in the quant section. And that is what I did when I tried to change that. I gave myself time limits and I worked pretty hard on that.
So even when you're practicing your handout or the study material that you're studying from, you used to time them, or was it only during
right. No. I gave it proper time limits, 30 okay. seconds per question.
Okay. And what was your thought process in case you're not able to solve a question in that time frame? So how did you cope up with it? Because people tend to get very demotivated or they get very stressed out when they are not able to solve a particular question. So how was your take on it?
What I did was I went back to the concept. I went back to that particular theory part, and I went through all of it, and I realized what formula should have been applied or what particular concept I should have applied at that question. And I think I reattempted it in a couple of hours, and I think that was okay.
Yeah. So practicing and going back to the basics again was your key. Right. So you started very early with your mocks. So till the D day, approximately how many mocks would you have given?
I think I attempted around 50 mocks till my D day, more than 50 maybe.
Right. And how did you analyze each mock?
So I started with the VA section, and as I said, I tried to understand my line of thought behind each answer that I marked. And with that DILR section, it's pretty basic that if you know the concept, you are able to solve that particular question, and if you do not know that particular concept, you won't be able to solve it. So if there was some question that struck me that I am not able to solve it, I look that concept up on YouTube or on other materials, and I redid that particular question. And what I did was, when I analyzed one mock, I wrote down that yes, this has been analyzed in my table or whatever I maintained. And after a couple of weeks, I revisited that particular mock. I reattempted that particular mock, and I compared my performance from previous one and the final one.
Right. So revision is the key for you, you say, right?
Right.
So you need to keep on going back to your basics, back to your mocks, and keep on revising. Right. During your preparation, like nowadays, people think a lot about who is setting up the paper, what will it be, how difficult it will be. But did you ever think about who is setting up the paper, or what sections will they come up with, what kind of questions they will put up? So what was your thought process when you were preparing on that side?
No, I did not think much about that. Yes, I am Indore is going to set up that particular paper. I did go through some interviews from the dean of IIM Indore, and I tried to comprehend his line of thought, how he works. And someone told me that the quant section is going to be difficult, and some other material said that the DILR section is going to be difficult. So as much as I got into it, it kept on getting confusing. So I just left that part aside, and I tried to focus only on that questions. That it's a question at the end of the day, and you have to solve it no matter who sets up the question paper.
Perfect. So quants being your weaker section, how did you start? Did you start from very basics, or how much time did you give to your basics first?
I think I gave a couple starting 4 months, I focused on my basics. And towards the end, I started to focus on the shortcuts and the tricks, because at that point I was for the quant section, what I did was for the starting couple of months or 4 months, I focused only on the basics, on the formulas. And for the last few months, I focused on the tricks and shortcuts, because by that time I was comfortable with the concepts. Also, what I did was I wrote down all the formulas and posted them on my wall, and day and night I was able to revise those particular formulas. whenever I came across that wall. So that made it easy.
Right. And what was your strategy on D-Day? What was the strategy for Final CAT Day? What was your, how were you feeling basically while going to the center? How was it, the experience?
So of course there are butterflies in the stomach the whole week, or especially the whole night before your exam. And I couldn't sleep like many other aspirants. So what I did was I woke up very early in the morning and it was really chilly, and someone had already told me to, you know, wear socks and prepare that way. In, you know, ek mahina pehle se hi said that you have to be in that particular zone, exam center wale, don't make your environment very, you know, quiet and peaceful, because wahan pe disturbance hota hi hai. So I just made sure my environment is just normal and not, you know, utterly peaceful. And on the D-Day, my slot was the third slot. And I just kept on scrolling through stories, the first slot people, the second slot people, how many questions are going to be there, because it was not clear in our time. It was a 2-hour paper instead of the regular 3-hour paper. So I, when I got to know, there will be around 75 to 76 questions and 25 questions per section. I think I made myself comfortable with the fact that, yes, I'll be able to do that within the given time frame. And I gave one mock on the early morning at 6 o'clock on the D-Day, which is, I don't think that is advice. And actually I did not score very well in that. I got an overall 77 percentile in that mock. So in fact, even I will not suggest that you take a mock on the D-Day, because it just takes your spirits really down, which it did for me. But after the exam, I think I was like, chalo, it's done. We'll see.
So all the mocks that you took, what was your lowest percentile that you would have ever got that you remember?
Okay, so one very big problem with me is I get complacent very easily. So when I get a 98 percentile in a mock, I just give myself a rest for a whole week, which I should not do, but I do. And after that week, when I take a mock, I get very low percentile. So I got a 67 percentile in one mock in, I guess, July. So that was the lowest.
Okay, so from 67, you scaled it to 98, right?
Right.
And how were things when you got to know that you've scored 98, the result day, how was it?
Yeah, so you get those score analyzers before the result, right? And that showed 99 and that. So I was pretty comfortable when I got a 98.88. And everyone kept congratulating me ki ab to top colleges se aayega. And of course, I was happy, but I thought ki 99 aa jata. That is the common, you know, mindset.
Right. So, yeah. And how was it after the this thing, after your scores? How was the GDPR process, or how did you prepare for your interviews?
Okay, so I think that was the most dreadful part for me, because honestly, I had not attempted any interview before this GDPR process. And mock interviews help a lot. And one problem with me is that I need to just calm my nerves down before I'm sitting in front of, you know, the person who takes my interview, because I know it has high stakes, right? And I just start panicking right sitting in front of the screen. And even when I gave mocks, some professors called me out on it, that why are you just, you know, shivering? I was literally shivering. So yeah, I tried to give as many mocks of interviews as possible, because that, you know, got me familiarized with the questions that I usually ask. And my first interview was actually very early. It was on 1st February only. And my second one was on 2nd February. And I did not have much time to, you know, acclimatize to the whole process. But I managed somehow.
Great. And you managed it very well, obviously. You have converted IIM Calcutta. Do you think being a fresher has, do you have any advantage or disadvantage over the others?
So, initially I thought that since I'm a fresher, I'll have a clear disadvantage, because I'll not have enough talking points at the time of interview, because about what you did for in your work ex. But the point, what it came down for me was that I was comfortable with my achievements during my college time, and I was able to explain to the professors with passion, of course, that yes, I devoted my time to this particular thing and I was good at it. I showed leadership skills, and during college also I had various extracurricular achievements and co-curricular achievements. So I was able to, you know, defend myself on that particular path. And I was interested in the field of marketing and brand management. So I had done a few certifications just out of excitement. And I was able to defend those certifications as well. And I was able to answer marketing questions comfortably. So I think that's what got me through, especially my IIM Calcutta interview.
So you think doing certifications helps, or you need to justify what you've done? What should be the practice by the future aspirants?
Yeah, so doing certifications helps as long as you know what you're learning. Especially for online certifications, it's very easy, you know, just go through the material and get the certificate at the end. But you're giving an interview and they'll ask, you're saying that I know marketing basics. And if you're not able to defend that line, then you don't know marketing basics, right? You that certification does not count in that case. So you should know your material. And even if you don't have that paper certificate, if you know the concept, I think that is better than having that written that, yes, this person is certified in so-and-so.
Great. That sounds great. Karima, what was the feeling when you saw that you've converted Calcutta? I mean, that feeling, if you could describe, so it could be a motivation for many future aspirants listening to you today.
When I got that message, actually, I was not very enthusiastic before opening that particular message because I somehow knew that it was a long shot and I had it in my mind that 99.5 se niche to ABC sochna bhi nahi chahiye. And the fact that I got the interview was a big thing for me in the first place. So when I opened that and I got that message, congratulations, I literally had tears rolling down my eyes and my mother was sitting right next to me. And I said that, Mama, it's done. I got it. And she just said, kya ho gaya? What's done? Why are you crying? And then I had to explain it to her. And then I went all around my house. It's done. I'm done. Ho gaya. Ek saal. Because that anticipation for an entire year, it just gets to you somehow. And sitting in the lockdown, doing nothing, not having, you know, friends all around you, it just gets to you somehow.
Right. It's all your hard work. It's all your high spirits. The way you practiced and revised each thing again and again, I think that played a big role during your competition. What would you be advising all the future aspirants out there? Last two pieces of advice, maybe quickly, if you could just guide them.
Yeah, so I would say that, as I've been saying for so long, just be clear on your basics. Try to attempt as many mocks as possible, because ultimately it comes down to how you are prepared for that particular pressure situation during the time of the test, and not just how many questions you can attempt. So the point is that you have to surround yourself with that particular pressure situation. And for the interview also, try to give as many mocks as possible. Be comfortable with yourself. And what I did was I wrote down a whole passage that who am I, what is my story, and what are my strengths and weaknesses. And you have to really dig deep and, you know, bring out those facts about yourself. And I think that will do it for you. Just take it easy, take a deep breath, and I think that will be fine.
That sounds really great, Karima. Thank you so much for joining us. Thank you so much for guiding all the future aspirants for Cat21 out there. Your advices will help many for sure. Thank you so much for spending some time with us. Thank you, guys.
Thank you.